Hello, welcome to Terminology Tuesday. This week we're talking about measurement artifact. I hope everybody got that right. Honestly, the scenario is the definition as well as the causes all in one. So if you can memorize the question, you basically know what you need to know about measurement artifact. But let's talk about it in a little detail. So what's very important is a lot of people sort of think that an artifact is a mistake or a bias, somebody measured incorrectly, but that is not correct. It's actually everything was done appropriately, right? Whether they were using time sampling or they scheduled the behavior to be observed, the measurement piece was done correctly. But something about the measurement piece is what creates this misleading picture of the behavior. So guys, as you know, with time sampling, one of the risks is over and underestimation. So is that data wrong? No. Does that data potentially over and underestimate behavior and therefore is misleading about what happened? Yes. Limiting measurement scales, that's another one. If you don't have a scale that allows the client's entire potential to be seen, then obviously that is going to be misleading about what they can or cannot do. So if you measure a spelling test with 10 words and then claim that this person can spell 10 words, that's not wrong, it's not incorrect, that's what you measured, but because of that limiting scale, you're creating a very misleading picture about what that client is able or not able to do. And then of course, measurement periods that are poorly scheduled. Again, is the measurement correct? Are they measuring what they saw? Yes. So it's not an error per se, but it can be misleading because that time period didn't allow equal opportunity for occurrence or non-occurrence or anything to do with the behavior and how it was measured. I hope that helps, guys. I'll see you next time.